So here we go. It's a best of five match. First player to win three games, games to 11, win by two. Mima-chan to serve. It's a nice quality point here. I didn't expect a few of these shots to come back topspin. Nice empty push there. Mima Ito with very little spin, catching Han Ying off guard.
Yeah, that was a nice deep return by Han Ying, but Mima Ito did well to play that ball deep herself and got the long return. Oh, great rally from both players. Han Ying, yeah, they're a little bit away from the table, and Mima Ito takes full advantage. She's moving extremely well already at the start of this match. She's moving to the extreme backhand and quick to return that shot from Han Ying.
Yeah, it's quite amazing when you think about the height difference. Mima Ito is not much above 5 feet, 152 centimeters, but she glides so quickly to get around those backhand corners for the forehand attack. And even with the backhand, it's tough to read. One thing when a short pips player attacks, it's tough to know how much topspin is on their shot. So Han Ying on the scoreboard here, coming into the first towel break. For those of you a little bit newer to the sport, players have the option to use the towel every 6 points just to make sure they don't stall too much, but it appears neither player needing it just yet. Still warming up, feeling out the space. It looks a little bit unconventional, the style right now. We've seen a lot of surprises for Han Ying. What do you expect to change throughout Han Ying's match here?
I think she started off, okay, she lost the first 5 points, but she's won the last two. She's trying to settle down into a rhythm. But Mima Ito, as of now, she's playing a lot of balls to the body of Han Ying. And that's the reason that Han Ying is kind of playing the ball a little long. A couple of them have gone out from the length of the table. The first game, basically, the players just used to kind of settle down. But in the shortened format, it's a really difficult thing to do for Han Ying, because if she goes down by a game, it's difficult for her to come back.
Now, we talked about the flat hits that Mima Ito has, but against these chops, she's playing it very safe right now, spinning it up with the forehand until she has a killable ball.
Yeah.
3-7.
Trying to play the quicker forehand topspin that time, just clips the net and goes long.
Smart play, quick timing right off the bounce. No chance for Han Ying to react to that on the parallel nonetheless.
Yeah, this was a great shot from Mima Ito. Few times now we've seen her taking the ball very quickly, almost on the bounce, and giving Han Ying no time to react.
Another parallel winner here. In terms of control and confusion against a chopper, causing that confusion, Mima Ito years ago, when she was a young teenager, I saw down 0-3, if I remember correctly, win four games in a row against this player here. Experienced, one of the top choppers in the world, Han Ying. That's been the sweet spot here. Forehand deep to the backhand. Coach Matsuzaki in the corner, as calm as always. And now Ito with 7 game points.
11,
an attempted floating chop, but as you mentioned, jammed right into the body. It's going to be everything she does to make the ball just whiz past the opponent. So Han Ying to start game two with the serves. Side of the table, that's Mima's point. She was very calm. She waited to see what the umpire said.
Yeah.
I think if I were in her spot, I would have been like, down, 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 that's mine. So that's the Mima smash, and that's often the temptation against chops. They sit up a little bit high, but the variation in the rotation makes it not easy to just kill.
Yep, and that was played quite deep as well. But Ito did well to play it on both flanks of Han Ying. She's playing to the backhand very well. And just trying a little bit too much there, but that's okay because, I mean, she's a game up. She's trying to get into the more powerful forehand topspins, and that one was also played to the center of the table. Ooh, so much of spin on that ball. It didn't come out once it hit the net.
Yeah, a bit of fortune there for Ito as the ball dribbled on the table for a second bounce to outright win the point.
Let 2-0. Let 2-0.
No limit to how many lets you can serve in table tennis. Good start, Ito, quick to that deep backhand corner. I think one thing that can be very effective against a chopper is the placement of the first attack, because they're comfortable having the ball hit hard at them. Once you get into the rally, that's what they do. They return the ball, they vary the spins, but while they're still close to the table, that's the chance to not give them time to react. So already tying her score from game one, Han Ying. Clever drop shot here. Ito leaving it out in front. Had the opportunity to kill, but thought Han Ying will be backing off. This will cause her more trouble.
Yeah, Ito had moved a lot in the front after playing this powerful smash, but the forehand topspin rather, and then just decided to play the drop shot.
It's funny, you'd mentioned earlier that Han Ying might try to stay closer. It appears that she's trying something completely different and giving herself a bit more time to react by staying back and making sure she can get the first chop in.
Yeah.
Ooh, strawberry.
4-6.
Good recovery here from Han Ying. I thought that opening attack from Ito was very surprising.
Yeah, the backhand flick was a beautiful shot, but an excellent return from Han Ying. And Mima Ito just caught a little bit close to the table.
7-4.
Mima Ito's serves have been some of the most, I'd say, unusual and creative in the world. And while she calls for a little bit of hygiene maintenance out here for the table, table starting to sweat, it's like she came up with something new just for this event. That's the Mima smash.
8-point lead in the second game.
Oh, killed down the line, just punished.
Nine, five.
Trying the deep return to the backhand of Han Ying. She's still got a 4-point cushion.
She makes it look so easy. Missed one Mima smash, but since then hasn't missed another.
And she's using both the flanks of the table very well. The last point when she played the forehand smash, she had actually played to the extreme forehand of Han Ying, this time to the extreme backhand. And Han Ying is just not able to anticipate where the ball is going to come.
11-5.
Well, that was it. Five game points, only one needed, 11-5. So back with the serves on her side. A lead of 2-0, Mima Chan with the serves.
Love one.
Catches the edge of the racket here, but credit to Han Ying for surprising that deep, quick shot.
Good return from Han Ying, not playing the defensive shot there. Though she was a couple of steps away from the table, she chose to play the forehand topspin instead.
And as you predicted, she is coming out with more attacks. Han Ying getting some good topspin in here. And it started with that Chiquita, the banana flick early on for Mima Chan. But right on top of the bounce, every time, I feel like when an attacker is playing a chopper and topspin comes in, it's easier for them. It's almost like a break. They don't need to put all their own power into it. They can use the spin coming in and just play with more confidence.
Yeah, But I think what Han Ying is doing, that even when she's attacking the ball, she's still staying a couple of steps away from the table. I think she needs to come closer to the table and really take the attack to Ito. I think that's the only way she's going to come close to Ito in this match.
Well, we'll see if she can earn herself that valuable real estate at the back of the table. 1 point lead for the German defender, Han Ying.
Oh, what a drop shot.
So out of the first towel break, the only towel break seemed to be for the table itself. It's so tough with the timing when you've got someone who spins one and then just flat kills the next.
Yeah, when Han Ying is moving away from the table, there's so much angle that Mima Ito has to play her shots.
And in near the table, a heavy push. Again, with short pips on the backhand, Han Ying can generate more spin than, say, a traditional long pips chopper. Long pips, very good at using the opponent's spin, not so much for creating your own. Ooh, bit of fortune here. Han Ying catching the edge. All it has to do is touch the top surface of the table in any way, shape, or form.
Yeah, she needs that bit of luck. It was a great shot from Mima Ito, moving away from the side of the table. But what a great return from Han Ying.
5-0.
It does seem that she's pretty clear on her strategies.
Six, five.
Strawberry once again. It's funny, several of the Japanese women are very good in the receive game with these heavy side spin shots. Strawberries, banana flicks. Strawberry once again and well placed into the middle, shutting down that backhand counterattack.
Seven,
that last
six.
One just high enough for Ito to really put the power on and drive through it deep.
A couple of forehand topspins from Mima Ito and Han Ying not able to play the ball low enough. And that's the reason that Mima Ito is able to play the attacking shots time and time again, a couple of them in a row.
I like that she took the opportunity to sort of practice the touch shot after the point.
Now, this return from Han Ying was a lot lower to the net. And that's what caused trouble for Mima Ito. 7-all.
Nice change of pace out here. Soft, shallow side spin. I will say one other thread about the point before. Han Ying comes running into the table, which adds extra pressure for Mima-chan to keep her pushes low.
8-0.
Well, now, a player who had not scored more than 5 points in any single game is now dead even at the business end of game three. Han Ying looking to extend this match. Wow, that angle is such a cool angle.
Excellent forehand topspins from Mima Ito. A drop shot in the middle, and then the last point goes straight to the body of Han Ying. That was such an important point at 8-all for her to win this point, and she's got this point, but she tries to play the third ball attack, sees a slight opening, and tries to go for a slightly quicker shot to the center of the table. But it goes in the net, and it's now Han Ying who's got two serves to come at 9-all.
The last two-serve combination you will see in this game right out of the third towel break. And a game point for Han Ying. Hadn't scored enough points before game three in games one and two combined to earn a game point. But she's got the serve on her side as well now. And looking for that kill shot. Very difficult to do when the ball's spinny and out in front.
And to keep the pressure on Han Ying.
We'll see serve back with Han Ying for game three. Excuse me, game four, rather. Yeah, the top spin just too familiar, too comfortable.
Love one. Two. Love.
Well, she's looking for the opportunities, Han Ying, to get in with that spinny, aggressive forehand.
Three, love.
We haven't seen so much variation from Mima Ito as we usually do. They've typically been the tomahawk serve so far. I wonder if she's saving them for different opponents later in the match or later in the event. Nice shot, quick off the bounce. And here you can see Han Ying's footwork. Again, the in and out game. Not much you can do about that except for brace for impact. Perfect placement right into the crossover point. Not room for a backswing nor a chop. A chopper stopper.
Six, love.
It's playing very consistently.
Six, one.
It's interesting watching her sort of think through what just happened. It's almost like we can see her studying and learning in real time. Quick debriefing and comes back for a backhand outright point.
Great shot play to the body of Han Ying. Nothing much that Ying could have done there. She was taking the ball off her body. Very difficult to do for a defensive player.
And we see that from time to time. Mima Chan will laugh a little bit in a moment where someone might think, why are you laughing? That's disrespectful. But she's just trying to keep herself jovial, free, and loose.
7-3.
Watermelons. These are those ones that sit up there. They look giant and crushable like watermelons. But the rotation is varied. The different depths on the table, not easy to flat hit. But her percentages are still very favorable for killing the, you know, the Mima smash out here has come down most of the time.
Yeah, the first time we've seen her smash to the extreme forehand of Han Ying in this game. She's creating a lot of angle, extreme backhand, and then follows up with the extreme forehand shot.
Three,
angle
nine.
Once again, and as she stays close to the table, staying dry there, using the racket as a fan. See that from players a lot. Though interestingly enough, as a defender, the head of the racket slightly bigger, so maybe a little bit more fan factor.
Ten,
steady play from Ito, spins where she needed it.
Ten,
trying to play the ball deep. The return deep, but she's got two serves now. No, I'm sorry. She's got one serve at match point.
There it is. The first one into the body, and the next one deep to the wide backhand. And Mima Ito has moved on.